It was 2005 when Leica and Panasonic put their brains together and came up with this gorgeous DMC, which stands for Digital Media Camera, FZ30 Camera. Let's roll. So, welcome back. This is Carmine from New York, photographer since 1973 here in New York City. Hit the subscribe button. Hit the thumbs up button. Comment below. It's all good for the algorithm to move this channel up and get noticed, which will inspire me to produce more videos. This is already class number 311. Who knows where this will go? Guys, this is the Panasonic Lumix FZ30. This came out in July of 2005. This camera, when it came out, let's get a nice close-up. Okay, hopefully you guys can see that. Let's see. Okay, so it has a gorgeous Leica lens on the front. Okay, it's a permanent lens. Gorgeous screen on the back, which is a flip screen, right? It flips down and around and down. And of course, it flips like this, right? So when you want to take secret photographs, right? I can go turn it this way, right? I'm looking at the screen, right? I'm looking at the screen this way, but it's taking your picture. Great for street photography. People will never think I'm taking their picture when I'm looking this way down the street. All right, I have a lot to tell you about this camera. It was $590 when it came out in 2005. Now you can find these gorgeous Panasonic Lumix / Leica lens cameras for $50 to $60 in mint condition on eBay. But here's what the best part is. Guys, the lens that's on here, a couple of things. Number one, it's a Leica lens. It's the Leica DC Vario Elmerit lens. But here's the best part. It's non-extending. Look at when I move the zoom ring, okay, which has an equivalent of 420 millimeters, right? And I'll extend it down to the wide angle of 35 millimeters. The lens does not protrude out. It stays all internal. Gorgeous. Now, the thing I want to tell you about this camera is, you know how they say a picture is worth a million words? Check out these photographs taken with this camera, and then we'll be right back. See what I'm saying? How gorgeous the colors are with this camera. All right, let's get into it. I have a few notes. I want to give a shout out to DP Review for helping me with this review today. Simon Joynson actually wrote a few notes for me. Okay, so it has a 12x optical zoom system. Okay. Not digital zoom. You know, digital zoom stinks. That's where everything gets all pixelated. All right. It has mega optical image stabilization built in. And that means that it will reduce the shaking. When you take a photograph, it reduces it, and to get crisp, sharp images without motion blur. All right. That's great. Come on, guys. For a camera that's $50 in mint condition with a battery and a charger, and I just checked today, there's hundreds of them for sale. All right. Now, a few more things you need to know about this camera, which they should be flying off the shelves. If it was up to me, there'd be none for sale. on eBay because Leica lens with that zoom range up to 420 millimeters down to 35 millimeters wide angle with the optical image stabilization. But here is the cherry on top. It's a CCD film-like sensor. Absolutely. Built into this camera is not a CMOS sensor. It's a CCD film-like sensor. You can take RAW, TIFF, and JPEGs. Now, the aperture range goes from f2.8 when you're at wide angle, and it only goes down to f3.7 when you're at 420 millimeters. Think about it. If you were to go buy a 400 millimeter lens, to find one that the widest opening is f3.7, that's pretty wide. You'd be paying a lot more than $50 just for the lens. Okay, the lens is 14 elements in how many groups? 10 groups. Non-extending, I told you that. The lens filter is 55 millimeters, which means if you want to buy filters for this, like I always recommend, you buy a Hoya filter or a K&F, right? This is the filter in the hood that I just took off, okay?
UV.
You have this to have filters, UV filters on all your cameras to protect the front element. Okay. It uses an SD card. Very smart. It's mounted on the side. The entry point for the SD card is mounted on the side, not on the bottom where the battery is, okay? This is your battery compartment over here, okay? Why is that important and why most people don't even think about it? When your camera is mounted on a tripod, when you have to take out your SD card and swap in a new one, you don't have to turn the camera and the tripod or disconnect it, undo it, put in a new SD card. No, it's all on the side. Look at the size of this grip. That is some awesome, great feeling grip. It has this rubber texture on the side. It has a finger groove here. It has a thumb groove here. So when you put your thumb there, you're ready to hold this camera. Yeah. Shooting modes. Full mode dial on top. Okay. Full mode dial. Will it focus? That's today's question of the day. There you go. Full mode dial on top. Meaning manual, shutter priority, aperture priority, program mode, and of course, a video mode. A video mode, it takes video clips and full automatic. All right. Here's what I really appreciate. As a professional photographer, this is what I really appreciate. The low ISO 80. On the low end, you can shoot your photographs at 80 ISO if it's a nice sunny day, like in this photograph. No digital green to worry about. Okay. The highest of the ISO range is 400, all right? That's okay, because remember, when we were shooting film, okay, 400 ISO back in the day, or ASA, that was like the limit, unless you pushed it and you had to develop it in a special way. Okay, let's keep rolling. So the light meter that's inside, okay, has centuated. You could use the spot meter, or intelligent multi-dimensional light metering. As an extra benefit, this camera comes with a portrait photographer's favorite built-in item, pop-up flash, to fill in flash when you're taking portraits, either outside or inside. But don't use it like that. Put on your under $10 diffuser, pop-up flash diffuser. It's just a piece of plastic. I'll put a pop-up right now to show you where I get it. Not a sponsor at all. I have no sponsors. I don't deal with sponsors. I just deal with giving you guys information. This is how it works. You take the built-in pop-up flash diffuser, this that I'm pointing to here, okay, slides into the hot shoe on top of the camera. Okay? And the flash, which is here, right? I'll pop it up again. Okay? The flash fires right through this plastic that has hundreds and hundreds of little plastic beads, which diffuses the light to give you soft lighting for your portraits. Look at this. It's so small, it'll fit into your camera bag with ease. This is probably the best under $10 accessory you can get. And you can take it off and use it on another camera and another camera and all your cameras that have a pop-up flash. It has an EVF, an electronic viewfinder, okay? Right in the back, that's an electronic viewfinder. And it has a switch right here where you can switch from the viewfinder to the LCD screen. The screen on the back, I will admit, it's only a 2-inch screen, okay? It's only a 2-inch screen, but guess what? It's absolutely fine. It's fine. All you're doing with this is making sure that you frame the picture correctly and that the camera is working, and you might use it to you go through your menu, okay? When you press your menu, it's easier to use this than to use your electronic viewfinder.
But that's all up right? to you.
Now, one thing we haven't really touched on is the obvious. Panasonic Lumix and Leica, two competing camera companies, okay? This makes for a whole nother part of the story. Leica from Germany and Panasonic Lumix from Japan, back in August of 2000, all right, 20 plus years ago, they started to collaborate and join forces. I wrote to Leica to get their quote on what happened, what brought Leica and Lumix together. This is what Leica wrote back to me. The cooperation between Leica Camera AG and Panasonic Corporation has existed since August of the year 2000. Initially, the companies had signed a cooperation agreement for lenses of digital audiovisual equipment, but 1 year later in 2001, the decision was made to cooperate in the digital camera sector as well. So this has been photo class number 311, where I've brought to you the DMC Lumix FZ30 or FZ30. The photographs that you've been watching and enjoying were all taken by me with this camera. I hope you had a great time. Be well. And this is Carmine from New York saying goodbye.